Well, good morning, students of standard 10th. I present to you the final video for this week, and we'll be doing the revision of Nelson Mandela's A Long Walk to Freedom. I will here present some value points that you should remember, and I will be breaking this story into parts as per your convenience so that it is easy to understand. The problem with this biography, autobiography of Nelson Mandela is that it mixes two issues and students get confused. So where one issue ends, I will stop it as part one, and when the new issue begins, I will mark it as part two. So you can keep issues separate and remember the value points as required. This chapter, as we all know, is important. It has a scope of getting lots of long answer questions. So let's begin. Nelson Mandela is also called the Gandhi of South Africa. You can see him with the FIFA World Cup trophy in his hand, because South Africa was the host of World Cup once, and the famous song Waka Waka was written to celebrate the festival. Celebrate the sports event that was being organized for the first time in South Africa. Now, let's see the important points in this part of summary that is possibly which has the possibility of being asked as important long answer questions. The inauguration ceremony, then how he figured out that he was not independent, he was not free, and what made him struggle so hard for South Africa. These are the three things. The first one is, in the inauguration ceremony, a troop of South African jets, helicopters rode in perfect formation over the Union buildings. Afterwards, Nelson Mandela spoke to the gathering about the sufferings of common man in South Africa, and that how the policy of apartheid created a deep and lasting wound in their country. He talked about the courage and struggle of comrades, that every time he has seen men and women risk and give their lives for an idea. The second thing he said was, which is important as a part of long answer question, is, I was not born with a hunger to be free, I was born free. Free in every way that I know. It was only when I began to learn that my boy way freedom was an illusion. Later on he says that these two sentences are not correlated. And finally, it was this desire of the freedom of my people to live their lives with dignity and self-respect that animated my life. I am not truly free if I am taking away someone else's freedom. Just as surely I am not free when my freedom is taken from me. The oppressor and oppressed alike are robbed of their freedom. So he said, somebody who takes somebody else's freedom is not free, and obviously if my freedom is taken away, though I am not free. So both are robbed of their humanity. While the oppressed is the prisoner of the oppressor, the oppressor is prisoner of hate. That's what he suggested. Now, who was Nelson Mandela? Nelson Mandela, if we give an introduction to Nelson Mandela, if there is a long answer question, the first thing we should say, who was Nelson Mandela? To South, he was the first democratically elected. He was the first president of South Africa who was democratically elected and headed a non-racial government. So, for the first time in South Africa, when Mandela became president, there was an election which was non-racial and democratic. Our elections are democratic, right? Well, he was an trained attorney, that you know, he later said, law-abiding attorney to a criminal, and he joined African National Congress in 1944. These are a few introductions. Basically, our story begins with Nelson Mandela presenting himself leaving to inaugurate there, or he not inaugurate, he was basically there for the oath taking ceremony. He called it an autumn day, and the reason was the month was May, if I remember correctly. Anyway, so it was an autumn day because the season was autumn, and it was, or can also be called an autumn day because it represented change. Autumn is the transition period between summer and winter. So it shows the transition from hardcore summer to soothing winter, right? Thabo Mbeki was the first deputy president, while D. Clark became the second deputy president. Finally, Nelson Mandela took oath and he set out. It was 10th May, right? So it was 10th May that he took his oath. And now, second is, he took a new pledge. He first had taken pledge to liberate South Africa from racial discrimination. When it was achieved, he took new pledges, and they were to free their people from the bondage of poverty, also deprivation, suffering, and gender and other discriminations. Racial discrimination was gone, but gender and other discrimination were still there, rich and poor and stuff like that. So he said, we will free it all. That was his first point. It was followed by the military jets making formations, right? And they were showing their pinpoint precision while of the military. The military general saluted him. And what was the salute symbolized? Symbolized their loyalty. They were showing their loyalty towards the newly elected, democratically elected, non-racial government. Earlier, they would have arrested Mandela because blacks asking for equal rights was supposed to be a criminal offense. So he was no longer a criminal. And you see, he had abandoned peaceful protest in 1961 and had become the head of African National Congress's new military wing. So now they were agitating with arms. He was sentenced for life in prison in 1964, and he was released in February 1990. So 36 years he spent in jail. It's a long time for anybody to lose their balance of mind. But somehow he managed to do and went on to be the president of South Africa. He also received the Nobel Peace Prize. These are a few things that you can mention in his introduction. 36 years he was imprisoned, he received the Nobel Peace Prize. This will make your introduction unique, better than introduction of given provided by most of the children. So he won the 1994 elections and became the president. Now, he also thanked the international dignitaries. And why does he do so? Because for he believed it was a victory for all mankind. A man discriminating against other, is oppressing people on the basis of race, a human being giving trouble to a fellow human being, was an extraordinary human disaster. And glorious human achievement was that was ended, and again equality reigned over there. And he thanked the international leaders for being witness to that change. And he said, since it's a victory of humanity, they also had a share in that victory. And of course, these countries had supported Nelson Mandela and his fight for equality. Now, there was another unique thing that took place that day. They sung two national anthems. Both the Dutch and the South African national anthem was sung, and by the people of opposite races. That showed that they were accepting each other. Now, this is the end of the first part. Then he says, it is not me who is responsible for this change in South Africa. Mandela goes on to say that it were their number of comrades who sacrificed their life, suffered for equality, and he was just a sum total of their effort. It was not only Mandela's effort that freed, the other comrades who stood up for South Africa were also responsible for this change, and he was the sum total of it. He further went on to say that he stood at the last of the line of the comrades who fought for equality in South Africa and stood in front of the line of the other people who would now, after him, take over the fight to make South Africa great. So let us keep it up to this. What you see is the prison where Mandela was stayed. Now Mandela was locked. This has been turned into a museum. We will take up this topic further in our second video. Till then, goodbye.